faulty, we had a faulty engine.
We sat in Iceland for damn near a whole month.
Dear friend, throw the wine. I'm in love with a friend of mine. Really, truly, young and newly wed. Are you a fool?
I'm not as nimble as I used to be.
Or is it true?
Radio is right in this area right here, and actually I faced forward when I was working, and I had a window right by my head there at that time. I don't know whether it's still there. I guess it is. It masters this side. Navigator was over on this area here. A bullet could go right through it without shattering it.
Or is it true?
Well, your radio work primarily was all done in Morse code pretty well. And I was tapping out all the time. I can still remember the Morse code. And I only slowed up a hell of a lot from what I used to do. About 1943 was the last time I was in the Catalina.
Okay, now is this similar to what you remember?
This is pretty well changed from anything we had then. As I recall, I think the pilot and co-pilot had a little bit more space here. Now, I may be wrong on that, but it seemed to me there was more space up
in the cockpit,
in this area, and the next compartment back was for the wireless operator on this side, and the navigator was on that side. There seemed to be more space in them then.
Now, would this plane have been built?
Of course, this is a Canadian-made CANSO, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, so
it was
yeah.
1944.
We brought some high-paid help back from Scotland one time in a PBY, flew them back to Montreal. Nice. And the one guy had to have a piss, I guess.
Yes.
And he didn't realize that we actually had a toilet built in there.
So that
you could even sit down and have a grunt if you had to.
Yeah.
We told him to go to the back.
Yeah.
He went right back to the back into the blister, and he tried to get the goddamn blister open so he could pee outside. He got pulled into the. We're flying around it. Well, we weren't up very high. We're only up maybe 5,000 feet or something like that. We never took the Kansas up or the Catalinas that we flew then. Catalina was the American version of the cancel.
So he almost got sucked out the rear.
There's a funnel. There's a funnel in the back of the tail.
Yep.
With a tube that just empties out the back of the airplane.
Okay.
There's what they used to call an Elson chemical toilet in the back.
Yeah.
And we've got, the toilet is still there, but we just lined it with a plastic bed. It's never been used since we've had an airplane. Our flights were open.
Wow. On 168 Squadron, we were flying libs then, and we had our own P-tube underneath the seat.
Yeah.
You had to have a leak, just open up and pee in the tube, and it went out of the hole somewhere in the bottom of the aircraft, trying to get my feet in.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Dear friend,
I'm all right, as long as I get my
what's the time?
Leg over the edge.
Is this really
okay.
Yeah. Really mean so much to you. Are you afraid? Or is it true?
I think I got pretty well everything down there that would be of interest.
Matters.
I got a lot of hours on PBYs, and I was very interested when I climbed aboard. It's not the same aircraft that we were flying. Jesus, look at the guns that are forward in that thing. He loaded the bombs. These things.
They're called cookies?
This is the one they call the cookie. When that thing went up, it cleared out a whole city block.
Is that right?
Yeah. Tremendous.